I like dreaming. Because dreaming can make you mine.
It's apple pie. All right. So I'm going to introduce you to Lisa now. She is one of my pro player partners. We have played several tournaments together. And we've won quite a bit together. And we're playing next month. The SoCal Classic, which is a Tier 2 tournament. The best players in the world will be competing against, again. We wouldn't have it any other way. We love playing at the high level. We are playing the Las Vegas Open together as well, that tournament that's right here. I encourage everybody to play that tournament if you can. You're going to see the best players in the world. You see the Kyle Yates, the Viv Johns, the Tyson McGuffin, Sarah Ansbury, Corinne Carr, Simone. I really encourage you to come watch. I mean, you see us older pros play, but we are not in the same league as these younger pros. They are fantastic. So a little bit about Lisa's background. She's played tennis for 47 years. She transitioned to pickleball a few years ago, quickly moved up the ranks, quickly, very quickly. She hails from Hump Desert area where Nationals is held. So, Lisa, why don't you give us some more of your background and tell us.
It's simple. I lost heart in tennis because I did everything in tennis. High school, college, pro. So after pickleball, or after tennis, I decided, gosh, I want to do something else. I love competing. I want to stay in shape. I want to stay fit. So someone introduced me into pickleball, which I think at that time was probably Barbara Wintrob, because she's in the desert. So I started playing pickleball at Freedom Park. I didn't have a paddle for like 3 weeks. And finally, I got my first paddle from Ron Schmeck. So anyway, I started pickleball, and I never looked back. Didn't miss tennis. I just started on. And then I played some tournaments, got really liked it. So I kept going, and then my first Nationals was in May 2016 in Casa Grande. That was my first Nationals. And then it just went on from there, and I just loved it. Just kept building up, kept adding on, and then I did really well in 1 year, and then I had players ask me to play, so then I started playing with some really good players. And Steve and I, like you said, we've played many tournaments, and we've done really well. And my other partners, I have various partners, just like all of us do. So it's just nice because it's fun. It's a different variety, a different style of play with each person. So it's very challenging to, get used to their different styles and adjust quickly. So I love it. So like you guys, I'm a student of the game, so I'm constantly working on my game. I'm trying to work in different stuff. For me, I'm trying to work in some more poaching, more aggressive on the short ball, and yeah, just different stuff I'm working on too. So I hope to share that with you guys, the stuff that I learned that might be able to help you, so you can sift through things that work and sift things that don't work. So hopefully you'll have some takeaways.
So, thank you, Lisa.
I have hit every ball in this quadrant, in this location, and he's going to hit to every corner. So the first ball he's going to hit to me, it's going to be here, and then the second one's going to be in that corner, and then it's going to be in the middle, so each corner. All the way around the world, and then we're
going to
go the other way.
Believer of following the paddle, right? That microfraction a second helps you get into position. All right, I'm going to make it a more difficult burn. Come on there. Then we're going to go cross court over there. I know these are kind of easy so far. Look at that, that was a tough one. Back into the kitchen. Now you'll notice that Lisa puts more armor drops than I do. Have you noticed that?
Just like that.
So, who wants to see extra sauce?
I do.
She said it first, didn't she? See that? She's used to high-level players attacking her. But as you can see, she doesn't panic. She's... Her, what's that? No, it's not all I got. You know that. You want me to give you Tyson McGuffin again? As you can see, these shots... really don't, the speed of the ball does not affect her, right? I mean, I'm not hitting it as hard as I can, but it's a pretty good pace, right?
Makes it look right, makes it look easy.
Where should you hit the ball? If they're behind the line, you should be shooting the ball towards their feet. And if you can't reach their feet, you should be trying to at least go to their backhand, where most players don't attack from back here anyway. Some do. But if you continue to get players' balls right here, what do you think they're going to do? You're asking to be attacked. That matters where they're at on the court. If they're in the kitchen, keep throwing balls in the kitchen. The further back they are, throw it at their feet or behind them. Don't get them waist high. I know it's not that easy. I get that. But those are the goals that you should be working towards as you get better at this game.
So you did have, but you ran it though.
Yeah. I did that.
So Lisa and I, about a month ago, maybe 6 weeks ago, I can't remember. You know, when you get old, you don't remember everything. Thanks, guys. They're going to, I put in a work order this morning to have these banners. Don't they look like this place is run down?
Beforehand, right?
Okay. So here we go. Come up to the line. Keep them deep. Look at that. Nice. Very nice.
Nice.
Winner.
Nice.
Ball. Winner. Now, Lisa had that really, excuse me, that really strong drive, made it difficult for Nina, but Nina blocked it back, and they were forced to stay back. Okay, here we go. Go ahead. Third shot drop, very nice. That was a nice drop, wasn't it? Jerry tried to cross me up there.
Phil Mickelson is right here. Plays left.